It is strange that you, being his child, should have regard for her, your mother, and have quite forgotten him. All of this good counsel you bestow on me is of her teaching, and of your own self you can say nothing. Therefore, take your choice, either to be of evil mind or else well-minded to forget those dear to you who said, but now, if you could get the power, you would show blame the hate you have for them. And yet, while I am doing everything to avenge our father, do not take your part and seek to turn me from it who take mine. Danger? Is there not cowardice as well? Would come answer me. What shall it profit me to cease my mourning? Or else, hear me speak. Do I not live? Unprosperously, I know, but well enough for me. But to them, the while, I am a torment. So render honor to him that's gone, if there be service there. You, Madame Hatress, you pretend to hate, but really you take your father's murderer's side. For my part, I will never bend to them, not though a man should come and offer me these gods in which you glory now. Yours be the full spreadboard, the cup o'erflowing. For me, be it my only sustenance not to offend my conscience. Thus, I do not ask to share your dignities. And were you more well advised, no more would you. So now, though it be in your power to be called your father's child, the foremost of mankind, be called your mother's. So you shall appear in most men's eyes unmeritously, false to your friends and false to your father's shade. Some people think I have feelings for James Avery, but that is just not true. But before he left, he did say something I will never forget. He says he's been studying the situation since kindergarten, that he made all kinds of like lists and charts, and he even held his own personal pageant. He determined that I was the prettiest girl in all of Danesville. And he said that the prettiest girl can give people hope and brighten their day. And isn't that just such a wonderful thing to say to someone, especially from a delinquent? So now whenever I look in the mirror, all I see is Eleanor Roosevelt. Only, of course, pretty. Well, I mean, Mrs. Roosevelt works so hard to help the poor and downtrodden, but could you imagine how much more she can do if she were pretty? And of course there's inner beauty, but inner beauty is tricky because you can't prove it. And I've thought a lot about this, you know, beauty and goodness in all the different religions. I mean, Buddha is chubby, let's face it. And Confucius is all like old and scraggly, and I imagine single, and you can't even see a picture of Muhammad. Was it the teeth? I don't know. Anyway, Jesus was always really pretty, you know, with like perfect skin and shiny hair. It's like God was saying, look to Jesus for tips. And I really don't want to be vain or prideful. So I just always remember what James said in his letters. There are only two things that matter in life. Youth and beauty.